Sulaiman ibn Yasar, rahimahullah ta'ala, a great scholar of Madinah Munawwara, a great faqih of Madinah Munawwara, from the seven well-known fuqaha of Madinah Munawwara. It is a terminology, al-fuqaha al-sab'a, the seven fuqaha of Madinah Munawwara. He was one of them. He and his friend, they traveled from Madinah Munawwara to go to Makkah Mukarramah for Hajj or Umrah. On the way, they stopped at a place beneath a mountain, and they both decided that one should go for shopping and the other will make preparations here. They wanted to have food. So they prepared a tent to stay for a few hours or maybe a night. One of them left, Sulaiman ibn Yasar rahimahullah ta'ala, very handsome young man, a faqih of his time, he remained behind. And on top of the mountain or a hill, a family lived. They had a house built on the mountain. And they had a young daughter who was also very beautiful. So when her gaze fell on Sulaiman ibn Yasar rahimahullah ta'ala, she immediately fell in love with him. And shaitan and nafs enticed her. And the only thing that was in her mind at that moment was to fulfill her desire with Sulaiman ibn Yasar rahimahullah ta'ala. So she was watching very carefully the movements of the two visitors. When she saw that one of them has gone, she came down and she entered the tent. And as soon as she entered the tent, Sulaiman ibn Yasar rahimahullah ta'ala's gaze fell on her, and according to the Quranic injunctions, he immediately controlled his gaze and he said, can I help you? So she said, yes, I am in need. So he said, money or food? So she said, no, I want from you what a woman desires from a man. Immediately Sulaiman ibn Yasar rahimahullah ta'ala started weeping. Because they had the fear of the hereafter. Fear of the hereafter, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is testing me. What if I fail this test? What will happen to me on the day of Qiyamah? What will happen to me in the grave? What if I die in this condition? What if I fail this test? Oh Allah, he started crying. Attention towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When this girl noticed him crying very loudly, she feared her honor. And she ran out of the tent and she left. When the other friend and companion returned, he saw that Sulaiman ibn Yasar rahimahullah ta'ala had cried excessively. His eyes were very red. He said, why are you crying? Or why were you crying? He said, I was remembering the family. See how sincere these people were. How sincere. I always tell friends that the people of the past used to do much but reveal little. And nowadays we do little but reveal much. We exaggerate, we lie. We all of us like to be on the front page of a newspaper. Some responsible people in the masajid, they do something very small and insignificant, but they feel so proud to be in the local newspaper, maybe on the last page. It's like a souvenir for them. Oh, we've done something. TV, YouTube, newspaper. He said, no, I was remembering the family, children, wife. He said, no, I know you. When you remember family or children, you don't cry so much. Tell me what happened. So he narrated the whole incident. When he narrated the whole incident, the companion began weeping. He said, why are you crying? He said, I'm crying because if I was on your place, I would not have been able to save myself. I am crying because I fear that what if I am placed in a similar situation. See how much fear they had. They both left, they went for Umrah, they performed their Umrah, and one day Sulaiman ibn Yasar rahimahullah ta'ala was sitting in the Mataf, in the Haram Sharif, in front of Kaaba, between Hajar-e Aswad and Maqam-e Ibrahim, and he dozed off to sleep and he saw a dream. And in his dream, he saw Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam. He said, you are so handsome, you look so pious, who are you? He said, I am Yusuf He said, Yusuf the Siddiq, because the Quran says, Yusuf, Ayyuha Siddiq. You are Yusuf the Siddiq? He said, yes, I am Yusuf the Siddiq. So he said, your incident with Zulaikha is mind-blowing. Zulaikha was so pretty. You were young and handsome as well. And you were given the opportunity to fulfill your desire with one of the or the most beautiful woman in the whole of Egypt, and you controlled yourself. Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam said, your incident below the mountain was more mind-blowing than my incident. Because I am the Nabi of Allah, and a Nabi is masoom. You are an ummati. Ummati is not a masoom. Despite that, you control your nafs. So friends, the objective in life is the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be acquired through taqwa. What is taqwa? To abstain from every disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if we fail, to repent immediately. Repenting is also part of taqwa. So taqwa, this is the whole package. To abstain from disobedience to Allah. And when disobedience is carried out, then to repent. And in order to become a muttaqi, in the initial stages we have to swallow this bitter pill of taqwa and exercise mujahada. Exercise mujahada. Come what may, I will not disobey Allah. Come what may, I will not disobey Allah. In order to make this mujahada easy, think that my Allah is watching me. In order to make this mujahada easy, what will I do when I die? What if I die in this condition? What will happen to me when I go in the grave on the day of Qiyamah? Sit in the company of the pious people. Engage in pious activities, da'wah. Go to mashayikh, sit in their company. Stay away from wrong company, wrong environments. Make your heart zakir, make your mind zakir. Bring the awareness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, realization of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In order to do that, associate yourself with a sheikh and slowly, slowly, slowly go through the exercises of adhkar and make your heart and mind zakir. And whenever a mistake is made, immediately repent. A time will come when shaitan will not be able to push you away. Mujahada, the ability of mujahada will become very strong. And when the ability of mujahada becomes strong, a person will enjoy his mujahada. He will enjoy his mujahada. And when a person has the ability to do mujahada, وَالَّذِينَ جَاهَدُوا فِينا لَنَهْدِيَنَّهُمْ سُبُلَنَا, then Allah Himself will guide us on paths leading to Him. He will Himself create ideas in our hearts and minds that this is how you safeguard yourself from this sin. This is how you safeguard yourself from this sin. This is how you safeguard yourself from this sin. So go from here with a firm resolution. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's attention is towards this whole gathering, because people have come not only from various parts of the country, they have come from various parts of the world. Many brothers have come from Denmark, Sweden, Norway. People have come from Africa also. So people have come from various parts of the world, and so many people are listening to this program at this very moment. So many blessed people have come. So many young people who may have been sinning until this morning maybe, but they have come all the way up to the Islamic Dawah Academy to attend this conference with one view only, that they want to please Allah. So these are all blessed people. These are all beloved people in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah's attention is, we can hope that towards this gathering, and let us turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and benefit from this blessed gathering and make a firm resolution that inshallah from today we will always keep our Creator happy. We will never sin. We will never sin. We will never sin. If we have to give our life away, we will give our life away, but we will not sin. And if overcome by shaitan and nafs, we make an error, we will repent immediately. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Ghafir, Ghafoor, Ghaffar, Wadood, Rauf, Rahim, Rahman. He is waiting for us to turn to Him and repent to Him so that He may forgive us, because He likes those people who ask for forgiveness, and He also likes to forgive people. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive all our sins, forgive the sins of all our associates, dear ones, near ones, and the whole ummah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all acceptance and accept this 21st annual youth conference of the Islamic Dawah Academy. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the opportunity to see many more auspicious